Great day, wonderful students. Very good to be with you again. I hope you're doing great. I hope you're keeping safe. You're not giving mommy and daddy a lot of problems. Do that and you'll be good children. And I believe you're preparing for your standard exams that can come at any time. You know, be prepared. It's the motto of the Boy Scouts. And I believe you're ready for that. Today actually is another day of a great English language encounter. And I know today you will be enjoying a lot of things in terms of English language. I remain Mr. Wambora Good News. Today we're talking about grammatical names and functions. There's a full revision, part one. What do we expect today? Now, by the end of this lesson, you should be able to recall all the things we've done on the grammatical names and functions, especially when it comes to nouns. You'll also learn new things about its application and usage, especially when it comes to classes of verbs and other information. Straight to now, various grammatical names and their functions, noun clauses and phrases, subject of a verb, of verbal group, object of a verb, of verbal group, complement of an adjective, complement of a subject, object of a proposition, in opposition to another noun. In our subsequent lectures, we'll be talking about other grammatical names like adjectival and adverbial phrases and clauses. Remember, when a subject is spoken about in a sentence, is the performer of the action, and it's actually underlined by the left-hand side. And when it's an object, it's the recipient of the action and underlined at the right-hand side. Now, when it's a subject of a verb, we're talking about singular verb among any of the four classes of verbs. And when it's object of a verb or verbal group, we're talking about verbal group here is a cluster of verbs. Verb here is a singular verb, like we said. Complementing an adjective is when it's completing the meaning of an adjective. You can also complement a subject or a noun, an object of a preposition, the other side, an apposition or in juxtaposition to another noun. Now, what are the points to note anytime you're dealing with grammatical names and functions? When a sentence is underlined at the subject side and it contains any of the verb or group of verbs, it is a clause, maybe a noun clause, verbal clause, adjectival clause. And when it is underlined at the other side of the sentence, it becomes an object of a verb or a verbal group. It could be phrase, it could be a clause, the inclusion and exclusion of verb. We underline. Later on, I'm going to be giving you a full discussion about the classes of verb. Any verb that has been underlined does not take part in adding to the function of that sentence. It has taken its part, maybe as a clause, because the inclusion of it will mean that that sentence will turn to a phrase. Now, what are the classes of verbs? Let's start with the primary auxiliary verbs. Look at them. Is is singular and is present. Was is singular and past, and is present, used with I. Are is plural and present. Were is plural and past. Been is the perfect. Being is the continuous. And be here can also sometimes serve as a lexical verb. If I say, please be still, that please remains still. But our becoming, in that sentence, becoming is, be is an auxiliary verb, helping the coming, which is a lexical verb. Look at can. Can is a present, could is past, will, would, shall, should, may, might, and others. Let me tell you something about the modal. When you're writing, like say, while we were young, mother would wake us up to go to the stream. Yeah, this is past. You can't say mother will wake us up. I want to say, when I was young, I can sing very well. That's wrong. You can say I could sing very well. Yes. And Maybe somebody brought something to you. You don't need to say, you shouldn't have done that. You can say, you needn't have done that. And inclusion of any of these in a sentence makes that sentence a clause. And exclusion of any of them makes that sentence automatically a phrase. What about the anomalous? Has a singular present, have is plural present, had is the past tense of both of them. Now the lexical, or lexicals are the ones we know primarily play with the action, the doing, some call it principle, some call it main verb. Take, break, dedicate, castigate, collect, pilot, report, jaundice, compromise, release, chastise, calibrate, segregate, navigate, record, judge, harmonize, pollute, ruminate, salivate, urinate, liquidate, defecate. Just name them, as long as they portray action, they are lexicals. I call them the LVs, and you can play with them in tenses. You say LV, normal, like come. When you say LVS, it's simple present tense, comes. LVING is present continuous tense, and we have LVED past tense, like came, took, wrote. If it's LVEN, it's perfect, like taking, eating, spoken, and thereabouts. Now, how will someone know that a sentence is a clause, a noun? Let's start with noun. Talking about clauses when you have a verb in it. Now, they start with possessives and noun. Possessive like are, their, my, her, and others. Look at that. Game, home, car, husband, they are all nouns. When you combine them together, they make noun phrase. Including a verb in it, we make it a noun clause. Look at that sentence. Our game was held on the 9th of February. Our game was. Because of the existence of was, there is a noun clause. And because it's at the subject level, it's a subject of the verb held. On the 9th of February, we held our game. Our game is underlined at the object level. Our game, because there's no verb in it, is a noun phrase and object of the verb held. Demonstratives like that, this, those, these can combine with nouns to make a noun phrase. That building has been standing there since I was born. That building has is a verb included there, makes it a noun clause, and it is the subject of the verbal group been standing. Yes, verbal group been standing. Being is a primary auxiliary verb, and standing is lexical verb in the simple present tense. Only nouns can represent as well. Roof, Lagos, and any noun. Lagos does not sleep at night. Look at it, Lagos does is a noun clause, and it is the subject of the verb sleep. At night, sleepless night, met Lagos. Lagos is underlined here, is a noun, and is a noun phrase. Only pronouns can also serve that purpose. Look at that sentence. That night, he came to realize that it was a tremendous advance. It is a pronoun, because in that sentence you have was. It becomes a noun clause. It is like this, object of the verb realize. So inclusion of a verb in a sentence is very important to making that sentence a clause. Now, secondarily, we can know that this is a noun clause or phrase, but especially noun clauses when it's introduced with a subordinating conjunction, like whether, that, not, if, that she's still alive is by God's grace. Yes, look at the underline. It started with that subordinating conjunction, and this is a noun clause there. Then we can have others. Whether he will survive or not is by God's grace. Whether he will survive or not is a noun clause, because it starts with a subordinating conjunction. We will have more examples on the function of this verb when it is introduced by subordinating conjunction and others. They can be introduced with relative pronouns. Who, which, whose, whom, what, that. Example, whoever told you that must have been deceiving you. Yes, whoever told you that is a noun clause, and the subject of the verbal group must have been deceiving. Yeah, look at the cluster of verb there. Must is a modal auxiliary verb, have, is an anomalous verb, been is the primary auxiliary verb in the perfect, and the serving is L-V-I-N-G, brought together. So we don't need to leave any of them. It is the subject of the verbal group must have been the serving. It can be introduced by a relative adverb, how, when, while, where. Look at that example. How a movie we sell depends on the author. How a movie we sell is an output. We can use nominalization. What is a nominalization? Nominalization in English is placing something that is not a noun in the position of a noun. We can achieve it through three ways. We can use infinitive too. Look at that example. To get visa to America is a noun clause. So and so is so. Some sentences sound like that. That the entire world is suffering is no longer the better. That the entire world is suffering is a noun clause. We can use gerund. Gerund is when you put lexical verb in ing to be a noun. I can say cooking is my hobby. Cooking there is a gerund, is a noun. I can also say I am cooking. In that sentence, I am cooking. Cooking is a present continuous tense. So it could be hiking is fun. It could be reading is rewarding. It could be any LVN you put in the position of a noun. Look at this one, Jerome. He reasoned that leaving his entire retinue of wives, friends, relatives, and well-wishers behind would be a bad idea. We started with leaving. And if you look at it, it's possible for a student to say, this sentence is long. It could be a clause. But if you watch the entire sentence, you will never see a verb. So that makes it a noun phrase. And it's the object of the verb reason. Yeah. Now, grammatical names and function and their formations. Subject of a verb or verbal group, like we mentioned, nouns can serve as subject of verb, verbal group. Now we're using subordinating conjunction. What the principal suggested was not practical. All these examples now, what is a subordinating conjunction, that is a subordinating conjunction, and all these other ones. We can also, like here now, what and that are subordinate conjunction. Whether can be there, where is a relative adverb, and so on and so forth. So, but what matters here is what the principal suggested was not practical, and that is a noun clause, and subject of the verb was. So we can see more example now as complement of an adjective. I am sure that things will improve. Let's go back to here again. Where we would find an apartment was becoming an issue. Here, we use a relative adverb to begin a noun clause because there's a verb in it. Whoever told you that must have been deceived you. Yes, we also have a relative pronoun here. And how a book will sell depends on its author. Yes, this is also relative adverb. So whenever you start any sentence with any of these, including a noun, a verb in it, it becomes automatically a clause. Now, as complement of an adjective, look at that sentence. Sure, careful, accurate, confident, absolute are all adjectives. Any of those beginnings like that, subordinating conjunction, not subordinating conjunction, whose relative pronoun and where relative adverb can complement the meaning of those adjectives and make them a noun clause, because where is a verb, offend is a verb, was is a verb, place is a verb, would is a verb, they become a clause in that direction. And they are complement of all these adjectives we mentioned, like sure, absolute, and confident. What about now as complement of a subject? Yes, similar to so-so-so and so-is-so. That assumption was that things will improve. The assumption was that things will improve. Now look at that again. Look at not again, where again. There are all those things that can begin a noun clause. And here it is complement of the subject assumption, yeah, complement of the subject problem, complement of the subject house, and complement of the subject rumor. Now also can also be object of a verb or verbal group where it becomes the recipient of the action. I can't imagine what made him do it. Now this year, what? Of course, by now you should have known those identifiers is object of the verb imagine. Why didn't we say verbal group? Can't. Remember, in the other one we mentioned cluster of verb, which we have something that must have been. Can is a verb, modus level, but there's a not in it, which is adverb. So whenever there's another part of speech that obstructs the flow of verb in sequence, it will no longer be tenable. We can only take the first verb that appears. Every other one that appears will be irrelevant. He was explaining how to start the model. Now, how to start the model is a noun clause. It is the object of the verb was explaining. Look at where it is. Complement and object will appear at the other side of the sentence. I was wondering whether she doesn't expect too much from her. This is another noun clause that starts with subordinating conjunction whether, and it is the object of the verbal group was wondering. She has decided that she will not marry him. Yes. If you underline that she will not marry him, it becomes a noun clause because it starts with a subordinate conjunction, or that can also be a relative pronoun. And it is the subject of the object of the verbal group has decided. Object of the verbal group has decided. He maneuvered how the incident happened. How, relative adverb. Starting the sentence and include a verb, it becomes a noun clause. And if you see there, it is object of the verb maneuver. The director stipulated that the arrangement be disorganized. That the arrangement be disorganized, now clause, yes, and it is the object of the verb disorganized. Now, as object of a preposition, of course, we know the preposition to, in, about, beside, on, above, beyond, upon, name them. And when these markers, representatives of noun, appear after them in a sentence with a verb like is, wish, ordered, should, imagine, rejected, or become clauses. So these are basically noun clauses, and it is the object of the preposition to, in, about, on, for, beyond, upon. Now, in opposition to another noun, in juxtaposition, look at this. The news that Abba Kyari has died brought some sensation and mixed feelings. That Abba Kyari has died is in opposition to that noun news. It's a noun clause. The announcement that the lockdown had been relieved was greeted with joy. That the lockdown had been relieved is in opposition to another noun announcement. The fact that this contract was signed was important is in opposition to the noun fact. Yes, it's been a very great one. Grammatical names and function. Thank you very much for being here. It has been time that we've learned so much. Starting from now today, we've seen so much about the various functions of noun. We've also seen the verbs that can make a sentence to be a verb and the exclusion of them making it a clause. That's what we've seen today, and so many other ways that we can understand that this is a noun clause or noun phrase. Come next class, we'll be looking at adverbials and adjectives. And before then, continue to read your books. Continue to get ready. Continue to make research. Continue to be good children. Stay safe. Remember, the height that great men attain is never by a sudden flight. It is when their contemporaries were wallowing away in slumberous sleep that they continue to burn their midnight candles at both ends. Stay safe and stay loved. I love you all.